Having known these E39 M5 since the day they were new, I don't think it would have looked this good when it was new, quite honestly. I mean, it looked brilliant in its days. But these are works of art. I mean, they are brilliant performance cars. They're brilliant driving cars. They're very civilized driving cars, but they are works of art. Yeah. This is one of the most beautiful designs BMW has ever made, and certainly the S62 engine in this is one of the greatest engines of all time. This car drives better than it did to begin with. Now the car. Love to tell the story of my friend who was the BMW engineer, one of the highest level engineers in the company, who's still one of my dearest friends. He's also retired from BMW. And when I wrote him a quick email to tell him and send him a picture of this car, I expected to get this big effusive, wow, congratulations, you know, you really ended all that stuff. And I mean, it was, he very quickly responded, and it was just one sentence, actually a sentence and a half basically, and he just simply said this: Ken, the M5 you have bought is a Bavarian masterpiece. Treat it wisely. That was it. That was all he said, and that has stuck with me, you know, and I will do that. It is a Bavarian masterpiece. Well, and I've watched him from the very earliest days when it was just Eric Keller here, and well, let's see.
What are we going to do today? So, well, that's a good segue. So, Eric Keller here, Enthusiast Auto Group. We are in Greenville, South Carolina, and we're with an EAG owner, and this is Ken Sparks, who has this beautiful Alpine White on Carmel M5, and Ken is certainly a no stranger to the BMW and the Mark, and
stranger to EAG either. For
that's true.
We got 2 years of history now.
We do, and it's been a really fun ride, and getting to know everybody is the part of it. And we've done a couple videos here and there together. And if you've not watched the video with this car, Leo, as he is now formerly named. In Monterey during Legends of the Autobahn, that's really when Ken took original delivery of the car. The handing of the keys, so to speak, was that really the making of that video.
That was his debut, frankly, to the world, and it really his debut to me, because up until then he had been just as he was and had been for the 17 years prior to that. And then you guys, you know, the few things that I asked you to do, and so when I saw him in Monterey, you know, all that had been done. And especially the difference with the free flow Dynan exhaust. Mm-hmm. And we went from being silent in the inside to just that rich bass resonant note. And the first time we got out on the highway. Yeah, you remember
that. That was fun. We had a cool little compound, a little EAG party, so to speak. And thanks, Justin, for letting us crash at your place there and have some friends over. That was a fantastic event. And prepping it, we jumped in the M5 and Ken got to rip down, I guess that was Carmel Valley Road.
Yeah, with Carmel Valley Road. That's exactly
that
right.
That was fun. I mean, you were laughing like a little kid.
Oh, my God, yeah. I don't think I ever smiled that broadly in my whole life.
I wish I had a better camera situation going on at that moment. It wasn't planned or prepared, but it was fun. And so it's been not quite 2 years, year and a half since you took official delivery here in South Carolina of your EAG M5. Tell us your storyline since then.
Well, you know, the most recent thing that I really have to say is this guy made it possible for me to get through COVID without losing my sanity. I mean, that lost year, you know, because the only thing we could do, I could get out in the car and I could drive. And being here near the mountains, one of the world's greatest natural test tracks, you know, all I needed was about 30 or 40 minutes in Leo, up the mountain, down and around and so on. And I'd come back refreshed, you know, had a bright new outlook on the world. And I mean, but it's that way every time I drive him now. And not too many miles. He had 29 and a half when I bought him. He's got 32 and a half now. So we do about 1,500 miles a year, and which is just just fine. I mean, to me, because it's special. Every time we're out together, it's a special event, and I make sure that it's really something that, you know, always has meaning. You know, I remember every one of them. I note them all down in my little notebook. You know, I'm a real nerd when it comes to that. And of course, you know, we call him Leo because that's his full name is Prince Leopold, the Bavarian masterpiece. He is that. I mean, the E39 M5 is BMW's true masterpiece car and will be for the ages. So, and to own what is one of the really very best E39 M5s in the world, thanks to you guys, is a great privilege. It's also a great honor. And I love the looks. I love the looks. They don't look at me anymore. Those days are long gone. But boy, the looks that this guy gets, I mean, there are more people that fall in love with this car than I'd say probably have ever fallen in love with me, actually.
Well, I mean, you had a 25-year career at BMW and kind of helped bring NA to really the position it is today, I think, in a lot of ways. And certainly...
at least its reputation, anyway. I mean, the communications, the image of the company, that was my responsibility primarily, both here, first at manufacturing, and then at the North American headquarters. So, and a great privilege that was, one of the greatest experiences of my life.
Yeah, well, and so you've seen every BMW in the last 25, 30 years firsthand, more so than others, and a car for life throughout your time and now here in post BMW days. And of all of the cars to pick, I mean, what were the main draws to the E39 versus picking any of the other cars that were standouts?
Well, when I retired from the company and I had been driving little M2s for a couple of years or a few years.
And you like those?
Oh, I love those cars. Well, I lived in Manhattan then, and that was the car to get around. It was just the right size and speed. I could get in and out of the taxis that were always in the way. And, you know, you could make those very tight turns without scuffing a rear wheel, which I did always in my 6 Series and my 7 Series when I drove those. So, it was the perfect car. I mean, always having been involved with the enthusiast community, I mean, you know, you can't show up in a new BMW at a classic car event. So, for personal credibility, you know, it was a matter of finding which one. It could only be one. And, you know, through all the years of in my head, I went through every one of them that I knew, that I loved, that I drove, and ultimately it all kept coming back to the E39 M5. And then I found the cars that you guys have and went from, you know, that whole page full of them, 5, and then ultimately when I came up to see you, it was down to the 3. And this one very quickly became the car of choice. And, and now we're showing it publicly for the first time. It's magnificent. But you know, I think I told you the story when I came looking for Leo. It was a matter of deciding. When I retired from the company, it was like I have to have a classic or near classic. And which one of all of the ones that I've ever driven do I really want to have? And our friend Eric turned me on to meeting you, Eric. Mm-hmm. And came up, and you know, and there was this treasure trove of E39 M5s. And
if you like analog M cars, especially of the V8 S62 flavor, we got them. And I got some other analog examples too. Another V8 up there. Whoop whoop.
That day that we drove them all, got down. I think we started with about close to a dozen. We're down to 6. Then it was 4. Then it was 2, and then it was the 1.
Yeah.
That was it.
Yeah, that EAG experience day that we've been doing for many years now with clients, and when they fly in and drive and see a bunch of different cars, and a lot of times we know what car they're coming specifically for almost all the time at this point now. But those are probably the best days of Evan and I's week or month. We don't get to do it very often, especially with COVID. That was a good experience that you've really created a bond with this car.
Yeah, very much so, because as I have told you many times, I set off to buy that sterling gray metallic Dinan S2. Mm-hmm. And I was certain that that was the car I was going to come home with. And then it came down to the 2. This guy, you know, it's just one of those mystical things. He spoke to me. I knew this was it. There was no question in my mind this was the car I wanted. And we have bonded. There's no question about that.
That's what we love to hear. And hearing that story how has your time been with the car, and catching up with our EAG owners after the fact has certainly been rewarding, and being able to support everybody. And you know, we haven't had any calls in your case of, hey, I've got a problem mechanically, help me out. And we don't get many of them.
And you know, and I said this to you guys when you were doing the full checkout and, you know, the rejuve, as you call it. One of the things I asked, I said, you know, I'm not really the technical guy. I want to be able to drive him and enjoy him, and I want you to put him in condition that I don't have to do anything to him till he hits 100,000 miles. So I've got about another 70,000 miles before I even need to bring him back to you.
that's what we're hoping for. You know, every couple 5 years or so, it's always good to do another checkup, whether it's with your local BMW independent shop that we've set you up with, or need a recommendation, we can help you with that if you need one. But you know, that gives us another chance to just stay ahead, that future proofing, and do everything we've learned over the years, because these cars do keep aging, and there are new things that we learn. All of a sudden, starters don't work on E39s. That's a thing, and that's something you're going to want to change ahead of time. That's really what we've always been striving for, is to make sure that our owners don't have to do much of anything, and we can make that responsibility very low.
It's true.
And
you've done a beautiful job, and the thing is, your reputation is very widespread and wide respected, and you know, people used to make a little bit of a kid about the joke that is about the prices that you charge, but then as people have gotten to know the cars, they understand why. Mm-hmm. And when people see Leo, even if they don't know me, and they look around and so on, and the first question usually is that an EAG car? And I said, yes, it was.
Well, that's, you know, I remember very fondly college coming up with the whole concept that is EAG, and I think I've told you this story a couple of times. I mean, you know, the one central goal was to build a brand that was synonymous with the industry standard of quality. Yeah. And let's make a standardized level of quality across the board. And if it goes through us, if it goes through our program, it's going to be the best. That's just what we wanted to strive for, and have that position in a consistent, predictable manner. And
it's true.
It's taken a long time
to get
there. And you've
done it. Yeah, it takes forever. But, you know, your reputation precedes you, and it's the right reputation. So
thanks.
So that's, it's absolutely, I wouldn't say that if I didn't believe it. And I'm proud to be one of your customers.
Yeah, well, we're obviously good friends too, and that is something that tends to happen with EAG. We all do these cars because we love them.
Yeah.
And we end up attracting like-minded friends. I mean, that's, you know, everybody here. It's like a reunion.
Yeah.
I mean, we get to see people we haven't seen in such a long time, especially, you know, with everything that's been going on last year and a half.
Yeah.
But it's been
because this is the first gathering since COVID, actually, to do this. And we've all been vaccinated, so none of us are wearing masks. We're immortal now, you know.
We hope so. And it's been a really fun day, albeit a little bit wet. But here we are sharing, and hope you guys have enjoyed the MX-1 video here earlier. And if you have any interest in selling us your E39 M5, we need more of everything, frankly. Thankfully, the guys that are reaching out do have some really great stuff, and we're able to keep them in really great homes, and that's kind of what it's about, because I remember very clearly the gentleman that we bought this from, Mr. Bacon.
Yep.
And his, I mean, he was an aeronautical engineer.
Yep.
And I mean, he kept a ledger, and a lot of our, you don't have to keep a ledger, but there's a good chance
it's
if you
do. It's
a
good thing to have. Yeah.
If you do, it's a good marker that guy's taking pretty good care of his car.
And he has, and knowing how well, I mean, Yeah. This is the kind of car you want to buy. You want to know who's had it before and what they've done with it. And
Well, inside, I got to thank everybody that's reached out over the years, because we are and become what we are because of the supply and being able to qualify the right ones and identify which ones we should maybe stay away from, which ones we want to run towards in this case. We definitely do appreciate that. So if you do have one, anything, especially E36s, as I was mentioning earlier, we just haven't had any good E36s in a long time.
Yes.
It's hard to find them in good shape.
Is. But I agree with that.
We got a long list of people that want them, that's for sure. But stay tuned for more. We got a whole lot more fun events to go to here throughout the course of spring and summer. And if you know that we're going to something, reach out. We'd love to say hi and shake hands. And
and now it's time to get out of the rain.
I guess this is our cue. Yeah. Cool. Thanks. See ya.
And the end result is I have a car for life, and I have a friend for life at the same time,
absolutely.
Too.
Absolutely.
And I appreciate that.
Yeah,
very
no,
much.
It's likewise, man.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Just enjoy the view behind the wheel of this thing. It feels so alive. As do I.
That's why we do this.
Yeah.
If the car's not going to bring you joy, what's the point?
Oh, you're right. The joy of driving.